पंडित ईश्वर चंद्र विद्यासागर फॉट फॉर विडो रिमैरिज गर्ल्स एजुकेशन एंड वॉज अगेंस्ट द पॉलीगैमी. माइग्रेन ऑफ पंडित विद्यासागर वॉज क्योर्ड बाई बाबू राजेंद्र लाल दत्ता. इन द टाइम ऑफ कॉलरा एपिडेमिक बाबू राजेंद्र लाल हैड अ ग्रेट सक्सेस इन ट्रीटिंग कॉलरा पेशेंट. बाबू राजेंद्र लाल क्योर्ड मेनी केसेस ऑफ मलेरियल एपिडेमिक इन बर्धवान डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ कॉलोनियल बंगाल. सक्सेसफुल होम्योपैथिक ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ बाबू राजेंद्र लाल रूटेड फर्म बिलीव फॉर होम्योपैथी इन पंडित विद्यासागर माइंड. पंडित विद्यासागर अलॉन्ग विद बाबू राजेंद्र लाल tried to convince renowned allopathic physician who was second MD from Calcutta Medical College, Dr. Mahen Lal Sarkar, to practice homeopathy. Pandit Vidyasagar came forward to help Dr. Mahen Lal Sarkar in collection of funds for establishment of India's first scientific institute. Scholars and intellectuals from all over India like Nobel laureate C.V. Raman used to deliver lectures on mathematics and science in the same institute. Pandit Vidyasagar was also suffering with asthma that once got aggravated in winter season. Pandit Vidyasagar had habit of taking one cup tea in morning and in evening. One day after taking tea, his asthma was relieved. He called his servant to inquire about extra ingredients in tea like ginger. Servant replied, "I did not use anything extra in the tea. It was usual preparation. I was in hurry, so I did not wash the kettle with water before pouring tea in it." Pandit Vidyasagar ordered him to bring the kettle. Pandit Vidyasagar was shocked to see two cockroaches in the kettle. He was genius, and in no time he doubted that relief in asthma may be due to presence of cockroach in the kettle. He did experiment to clear his doubt. He boiled cockroaches in water, took the extract, and used the extract in his asthma. He concluded that cockroach extract was giving some relief in asthma. Later on, Dr. Dwarika Nath Ray thoroughly proved Blatta Orientalis. Pandit Vidyasagar advised his brother Shri Ishan Chandra Bandopadhyay to practice homeopathy. Dr. Paresh Nath Bandopadhyay, son of Shri Ishan Chandra, also practiced homeopathy. He declined the post of deputy magistrate offered by Britishers. Later on, he settled in Mihijam in Karmatar, Jamtara district of present-day Jharkhand. Pandit Vidyasagar was inspiration for Dr. Pratap Chand Mozumdar, who married a widow, for which he was boycotted by his society, friends, relatives. Birth of his first child further added his financial trouble. In those days of troubles, Pandit Vidyasagar helped him. Pandit Vidyasagar and Dr. Mahen Lal often visited each other. They shared and discussed their homeopathic knowledge and prescription. Pandit Vidyasagar gifted his book, Homeopathic Therapeutics by Samuel Lilienthal, to Dr. Mahen Lal Sarkar. Dr. Mahen Lal gifted his book, Analytical Therapeutics by Constantine Haring, to Pandit Vidyasagar. Pandit Vidyasagar spent last 18 years of his life in tribal area of Karmatar. Railway station of Karmatar has been renamed to honor Pandit Vidyasagar. Pandit Vidyasagar erected a bungalow with a school for educating girls and adults in the premises. Pandit Vidyasagar used to give food, clothes and homeopathic medicines to the tribes of that area. Pandit Vidyasagar relieved suffering humanity with homeopathic medicines in the cases like boil, uterine cancer, acidity, diarrhea, abdominal pain, sprains, female genital tract infections, stomach pain, menstrual irregularities. Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar
seeded homeopathy among masses by distributing free homeopathic medicines. He convinced many intellectuals and scholars to take homeopathy as a profession. His role in spread and development of homeopathy will always be remembered.